It's about summer. It's not about all these freaking people fighting on YouTube. Because you know what? I'm standing up for summer and summer only. The only people that matter that I told the truth to was law enforcement, TBI, and all that. That's all that matters. How hard it would be for me not to go scoop her up in my arms and give her a hug and love on her?
How would you feel if you were the parent of a missing child, called every name under the sun, and you refuse, you absolutely refuse to listen to what they have to say? How would you feel?
Y'all can hate on me, y'all can dislike me, but when the truth really comes out and it really happens, and when y'all decide to say, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to do that, I'm not even going to, you know what, I'm not going to acknowledge them because of how much hate they have put into my heart.
And that's really sad. A soul destroying.
It's been almost a year and a half since Summer Wells went missing from her home in the Beach Creek community of Hawkins County.
Candace don't know if she could handle that. And she broke down and cried on us the other night.
Scoop her up and tell her how sorry I am. And
I know. Deep breath, Candace.
I'm trying.
We have to prepare ourselves for the worst case scenario. You know, we could always hope for a good scenario, but, you know, it can't be good because no matter what situation she's in, she's lost her freedom. Even if she's alive, she's lost her freedom. She can't be seen in public. I mean, I don't really want to celebrate her birthday without her.
A time where he will wonder what she would be like as a seven-year-old.
She was definitely going to be tall, I'd say, because she was growing so fast. And I'm sure she would be the same person. And she didn't have no qualms about taking on her brothers, that's for sure. She didn't hesitate to put them in their place real quick.
Don Wells says that even though there has not been any new leads in Summer's case recently, he's hopeful that by keeping her name in the news, there will continue to be some new information shared with police.
A girl so full of life and wonder, with the love for swinging and being outdoors yonder, barefoot and carefree, she'd run and play while her family watched her every day. Her three older brothers, protective and strong, watched as her sister danced along. But one day she vanished without a trace, leaving behind an empty space. Her parents and siblings, brokenhearted, search for answers, but their path is uncharted. Wondering who have taken their little girl and wishing for answers to unfurl. She was a tom girl with the princess's heart. Kissing fish and being silly was just her part. Her absence is felt in every way, and her family and friends pray for her safe return each day. May she be found and brought back home to the ones who love her and never let her roam. But until then, we hold on to hope and cherish the memories and love that they've spoke.
Wow.
Aw, that's beautiful.
Wow, that's so beautiful.
Yeah. And she wrote that with her heart, no doubt.
That was beautiful, Lean On Me.
That was beautiful, Lean On Me. She said it took her days to write. That's beautiful, Lean On Me. Thank you, Lean On Me.
That's very beautiful.
Why can't we just be kind, y'all? Why can't we just be kind?
There goes my heart beating, 'cause you are the reason I'm losing my sleep. Please come back now. And there goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hopeless now. I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what. the reason. There goes my head shaking, and you are the reason. My heart keeps bleeding, and I need you now. And if I could turn back the clock, I'd make sure the light defeated the dark. I'd spend every hour of every day keeping you safe. And I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I've broken. Oh, 'cause I need you to see that you are the reason. I don't wanna fight no more. I don't wanna hurt no more. I don't wanna cry no more. Come back, I need you. You are the reason. Just a little closer. Come a little closer. I need you to hold me tonight. I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I've broken. 'Cause I need you to see that you are the reason.
I don't know anybody in this world that would not love her because she's so beautiful and so outspoken and just so wonderful to the whole world.
I always pray that somebody would take me and let Summer go.
Oh, I know.
I sit here and I blame myself. I blame myself. I always have and always will. And I'm like, what if I would have went in the house with her and played with her? What if I would have done this different? What if I'm done that different? I always blame myself. I always have and I always will.
Like I was like a drone or something. It was kind of odd, but she was just running in a field with that Johnson grass. It was a beautiful summer day, and she was just running and laughing like she had just a big smile on her face like she always does. And, and it's just like I kind of flew by her and then flew up into the air, and I was looking back, kind of looking down on her a little ways from a distance, you know, like I was like a drone or something. It was kind of odd, but yeah, in that sense, but it was beautiful. She's got a beautiful smile with her running. It brings tears to my eyes thinking about it.
The dream that I had, I'll just go ahead and tell you, I was at a construction site, but this was a commercial construction site. And I haven't done commercial since I left Houston. But this had these real big steel studs in it. And the day was just, it was more beautiful than any day I've ever seen in my life. It was like perfect. And this building I in was beautiful, and I was working on it. And Summer was sitting there on the floor playing with her dolls or something. And she was dressed beautifully. I've never seen her so more beautiful. And it just, the dream was like heaven, I guess you could say. And I said, Summer, where were you? And she says, down the road, you know. And it was just like a perfect, beautiful dream, you know, that I can't explain. I haven't had no other dream since whatsoever. And then Candace's dream was that they were fishing, her and Summer. And she caught a fish, and she was really super happy, and she reeled it in, she'd give it huggies and kisses and let it go, and that was the end of her dream. And then had a woman in Florida contact me, said that she had a dream, and she said something about take care of Yucky, you know, and make sure to tell Daddy take care of the dogs and stuff. And the woman's asked me, what does Yucky mean? And I says, that was her dog named Lucky. She couldn't say Lucky, so we called it Yucky. And that's how the goddess name, and she couldn't pronounce it lucky. And a woman in Canada had a dream that she was sitting there on a bench with her, a swing on a porch. She says, "Can I tell you a secret?" She says, "I miss my daddy. I used to stroke her hair." And tell her I love her. And I told her that's what I used to do that all the time.
Like in your heart that she's still alive, Candace?
I know she is.
You know, a mom can sense that, you know? They can sense that.
I know she's still alive, and I know somebody has her.
I just pray that they can find out soon enough.
And what makes me the maddest is I think they've got her, and they know that they got her. Every night and every day that whoever has her is not hurting her.